want to do? Do you want to make them completely whole, or are you asking for to be made partially whole, or?
We're asking for the 25. We're asking for the actual amount. Yeah, that they would have gotten.
So since the rainy day fund is a finite amount of money, what's next? Once the resource is depleted out of whatever fraction of the rainy day fund you're requesting, what then after that? What is the, you know, what is the end result after that? How do you then keep replenishing that funding in order to sustain those communities?
Yeah, that's not the focus of the legislation. The focus of the legislation is, again, going back to what the governor said in front of the Inquirer, and what he said to all the freshmen. These are communities whose bank balance is clearly below what the state average is. So again, it's only 1% of the rainy day fund. If the conditions of East Cleveland were being felt across Ohio by all 11 million Ohioans, we'd be dipping into that rainy day fund. That's essentially what I'm, the point of this is the rainy day fund. The current balance of the rainy day fund is not 26 million, and we're going to try to take 98% of it. That's a different discussion. It's 2 billion. It's doing nothing for the good of Ohioans right now. We're trying to take 1%.
Do you have any idea, has anyone got the number of how many communities throughout the state have raised local taxes to compensate for loss of state government funds? Is that number out there?
I don't have it off the top of my head. I've seen a study recently, but I focused in on my communities and frankly, Cuyahoga County. So I can't even remember how big that, whether or not that was a full statewide study.
When you guys hear Governor Kasich talk about the Ohio Miracle as he's campaigning throughout the United States, and he talks about the jobs coming back and the communities are healthy and we've got a healthy budget line and all and everything. What are you thinking every time you hear that? Or are you?
Yeah, I have to. I'm thinking about, the fact that a house fire spread. I'm thinking about intersections that don't have traffic lights. I'm thinking about seniors that were getting $200 to $300 for services, and now they're not. The fact is, the Ohio Miracle, again, is spin, it's not really reality. Our median household income has been below the national average, and continues to kind of drop below the national average. We're 7th in population, we're 10th in private sector job growth. If things were average, we would be at least 7th on that, on that matrix. And again, the governor has balanced his budget on the backs of others. The budget surplus currently is $2 billion. The cuts to local government are $1.7 billion. If you factor in cuts to public education, you're now beyond $2 billion. So he's done a very nice job of running for president. I'm not sure he's done a great job being governor. What's interesting also in this March 25th article, from March 25th, 2014. So he's running for re-election to governor right now. They ask him, are you planning on running for president? And his answer was, quote, I don't have a calling for higher office. Maybe